next. Standard for life. Emmanuel, Matthew 1:23. Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call him Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Jesus Christ still empowers his followers to change the world today. Distance is not a barrier to God's move. Emmanuel TV, God with us.
God does nothing without his word. God's word is his gift to mankind. When we read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, we see that Christ and his word are one. God's word reflects his character and points us the way to salvation, healing, deliverance, and all of God's blessing. By looking into the word and acting on it, we bring Jesus Christ on the scene. Bring Jesus on the scene. The living word must live in you, grow in you, and get into your blood to gain supremacy over you. Learn to dream again as we look to God through his word by his spirit. Get ready to open your heart to God's word, faith, and spirit as we listen to what God has to say in today's Standard for Life.
By his grace, I am what I am in Christ Jesus. God chooses grace rather than works. Not the work of righteousness which we have done. He knows we are weak. That is why he chooses grace. If the weak come to him, is ready to help their weakness, just as he will help the strong. He knows our limitation. He knows our shortcoming. That is why he chooses grace. By his grace, God looked at a murderer, Moses, and saw in him a deliverer. By his grace, God looked at Saul, a state persecutor, and saw Paul, an apostle. What is your situation? Grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. Tell your neighbor. In the soul is a new life in the soul. I mean, a regenerate sinner becomes a living soul. Ephesians 2 verse 8. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. This is not from yourself. Our spiritual life resource from our union with Christ. Remember, God is spirit, and those who worship him in spirit and truth. Our spiritual life resource from our union with Christ Jesus. It is in him that we live, move, smile, have our being. That's what I want to say, by his grace. It appears that all is of grace because all our spiritual advantages are from God. Our faith, our conversion, our internal salvation are not the mere product of any natural abilities. Your neighbor, by his grace. This explains why a young rustic and seemingly inexperienced tactless David could stand before giants. In battle and defeated. Are you talking of the issue of Moses? Moses was a Hebrew slave. Stand before the king Pharaoh to make known the will of God concerning his people. Let someone say, grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. Tell your neighbor, by his grace. This is why we have many handicapped people becoming men of substance. Why able-bodied men live out their days unnoticed, uncelebrated, and in obscurity? Tell your neighbor, by his grace. There is no room for any man's boasting of his own abilities and power. This explains weak people like me, who without fast legs smoothness of tongue, ability to inspire people, who without great strength, TB Joshua, should ever remain graceful for the purpose he has designed me for.
Grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. Be blessed as you listen to this encouraging message by TB Joshua, titled By His Grace.
Emmanuel, if God is with us, who can be against us? If God is with a nation, hallelujah. Our proof test shall be taken from the book of Ephesians 2, As for you, you are dead in your transgressions and sins in which you used to live when you followed the way of this world and of the ruler of the kingdom of the air, the spirit who is now at work in those who are disobedient. All of us also live among them at one time. Verse 8. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourself, it is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. For we, God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do, that is predestined. Whatever you see today is a product of God's grace. God chooses grace rather than works. This will take us to the message titled, By His Grace. Let someone say, by His Grace.
By His Grace.
By His Grace, you are what you are in Christ Jesus. Tell your neighbor, by His Grace, I am what I am in Christ Jesus. God chooses grace rather than works. Not the work of righteousness which we have done. He knows we are weak. That is why He chooses grace. If the weak come to Him, He's ready to help their weakness, just as He will help the strong. He knows our limitation. He knows our shortcoming. That is why He chooses grace. When you take that reading from verse 8, for it is by grace you have been saved through faith. Let no one boast. All we call our works are like filth rags before God.
By His Grace.
By His Grace, God looked at Daniel, a slave, and saw in him a leader. By His Grace, God looked at a murderer, Moses, and saw in him a deliverer. By His Grace, God looked at Saul, a state persecutor, and saw an apostle. Grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. Tell your neighbor.
By His Grace.
Let someone say, by His Grace. Grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. I mean, a regenerate sinner becomes a living soul. Ephesians 2, verse 8. For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith. This is not from yourself. Our spiritual life results from our union with Christ. Remember, God is spirit, and those who worship him in spirit and truth. Our spiritual life results from our union with Christ Jesus. It is in him that we live, move, smile, have our being. That's what I want to say, by his grace. It appears that all is of grace, because all our spiritual advantages are from God. Our faith, our conversion, our internal salvation are not the mere product of any natural abilities.
So I'm here today because God kept me. I'm alive today only because of his grace. He kept me. God kept me. He kept me. So I wouldn't let go. So I'm here today. Here today. Because God kept me. I'm alive today. Alive today. Only because of him. Oh, oh, he kept me. God kept me. God kept me. Oh, he kept me.
Thank you, thank you. You may be seated. All these things are not brought to pass by anything done by us. It is not by power or might. All this, teaching, preaching, healing, deliverance, whatever you see, is a product of God's grace. These things are not brought to pass by anything done by us. Therefore, all boasting is excluded. Tell your neighbor, all boasting is excluded. Are you a child of God? Everything about you is a product of God's grace.
By his grace.
Grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. I mean, a regenerate sinner becomes a living soul. Ephesians 2, verse 8. For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith. This is not from yourself. Our spiritual life resource from our union with Christ. Remember, God is spirit, and those who worship him in spirit and truth. Our spiritual life resource from our union with Christ Jesus. It is in him that we live, move, smile, have our being. That's what I want to say, by his grace. It appears that all is of grace, because all our spiritual advantages are from God. Our faith, our conversion, our internal salvation are not the mere product of any natural abilities.
By his grace.
If you ask me to move one orange here, okay, you say, at your mark, said go. I catch first and I run back first. As a Christian, I must leave the issue for God. After I must have done everything humanly possible, I must leave the issue with God. God must mark it. After struggling, after hard labor, God will still have to mark our walk. That is grace. Because all our spiritual life resource from union with Christ. It is in him that we live, we move, we think, we smile, we laugh, we joke, we walk, we sleep. Just think of it. It's not by power.
It's not by might.
It's not by might.
But by my Spirit, says the Lord. Oh, it's not by power.
You may be seated. This explains why a young rustic and seemingly inexperienced tactless David could stand before giants. In battle and defeated.
By his grace.
Jesus Christ clearly links faith to forgiveness. If we are not forgiving, let someone say, if we are not forgiving, the power of faith is short-circuited. Why? Because a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to redeem. Have you forgiven your brothers? If you must receive, you must learn to plant. If we are not forgiving, the power of faith is short-circuited. Why? Because a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to redeem, to... This is why we have many handicapped people becoming men of substance. Why able-bodied men live out their days unnoticed, uncelebrated, and in obscurity? Tell your neighbor, by His grace. There is no room for any man's boasting of his own abilities and power. This explains weak people like me, who without fast legs, smoothness of tongue, ability to inspire people, who without great strength, TB Joshua, should ever remain graceful for the purpose He has designed me for.
By His grace.
This explains why a young rustic and seemingly inexperienced tactless David could stand before giants. In battle and defeated. Are you talking of the issue of Moses? Moses was a Hebrew slave stand before the king Pharaoh to make known the will of God concerning his people. Let someone say, grace in the soul is a new life in the soul.
You raise me up.
can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up, you raise me up, so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can. You raise me up, you raise me up.
You raise me up, oh, I can stand on mountains.
Yes, you raise me up.
You raise me up to walk on stormy seas.
I am strong, I am strong when I am on your shoulders.
You raise me up to more than I
can. You raise me up, you raise me up.
Hallelujah. You listen to that? Thank you. You may be seated. This is why we have many handicapped people becoming men of substance. Why able-bodied men live out their days unnoticed, uncelebrated, and in obscurity? Tell your neighbor, by his grace.
By his grace.
By his grace. This is why we have many handicapped people becoming men of substance. Why able-bodied men live out their days uncelebrated, unnoticed, and in obscurity? These things are not brought to pass by anything done by us. It is by his grace. There is no room for any man's boasting of his own abilities and power. This explains weak people like me, who without fast legs smoothness of tongue, ability to inspire people, who without great strength, TV Joshua, should ever remain graceful for the purpose he has designed me for.
I'm forever grateful to you. I'm forever grateful for the cross.
You may be seated. Thank you. Mark 11, verse 25. And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive him, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sins. Jesus Christ clearly links faith to forgiveness. If we are not forgiving, let someone say, if we are not forgiving, the power of faith is short-circuited. Why? Because a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to redeem. Have you forgiven your brothers? If you must receive, you must learn to plant. If we are not forgiving, the power of faith is short-circuited. Why? Because a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to redeem. He will misappropriate it. She will hurt herself and others with it. Have you forgiven? It's not too late. Tell your neighbor, a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to save, to redeem. Because when you are not forgiven and you are given this power, you will hurt yourself and others with it. You misuse it. This is why Jesus clearly links faith to forgiveness. So let's pray. By his grace, God looked at Daniel, a slave, and saw in him a leader. By his grace, God looked at a murderer, Moses, and saw in him a deliverer. By his grace, God looked at Saul, a state persecutor, and saw an apostle. What is your situation? Grace in the soul is a new life in the soul. Tell your neighbor.
Grace, how sweet.
Right now, lift up your lips and say, oh Lord, look at me, a sinner, and forgive me all my sins. Have mercy on me and grant me my petition before you. Prayer.
Look at me, oh Lord, and answer my prayer. Restore my strength. Don't let me down. Look at me, oh Lord, and answer my prayer. Restore my strength.
Turn a murderer to a deliverer. I know you can turn around my situation. Lord Jesus, turn around my situation. Prayer.
Seigneur Jésus, tu as transformé un meurtrier en libérateur. Tu peux changer ma situation aujourd'hui. Priez.
Be magnified, oh Lord. You
Christ's name we pray. You turn Moses, a murderer, to deliverer. You wiped tears of barrenness from Hannah's eyes. You can also turn the situation of my life today around prayer.
Dites Seigneur, toi qui as changé la vie de Moïse en meurtrier et en libérateur, tu as effacé l'arme de la vie de Anne, tu peux changer ma vie. Priez.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Your word change not. You wipe away tears of barrenness from Anna's eyes. By His grace, this is your day. If that word is true for your life, let me see your excitement. This is your day. This is your day. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, this is my day. Jesus Christ clearly links faith to forgiveness. If we are not forgiving, let someone say, if we are not forgiving, the power of faith is short-circuited. Why? Because a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to redeem. Have you forgiven your brothers? If you must receive, you must learn to plant. If we are not forgiving, the power of faith is short-circuited. Why? Because a person who does not love or will not forgive cannot be entrusted with that kind of power to heal, to bless, to deliver, to redeem, to... I call you because there is a reconciliation that is going on in your house.
That's true. That's correct, sir.
Is the prayer you offer now?
Thank you.
Will I accept this or I should disregard this?
That's correct, sir.
I want you to carry go along. This is the second time this trouble is happening in your house. So I think enough is enough. What the woman has done, it has done the worst.
That's correct. Very, very correct, sir. My elder sister sold the blocks I molded to build a house. When I got there, I found that there was no block. She shattered the lorry, sold everything. When I went to her, she said, "Is that why you came?" I said, "Yes." That she sold it and she used the money to eat.
Your own property, your asset.
Yes, my immediate senior sister.
When you get them, just call them, you forgive. You are not going to sit down face to face.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because it's a trap of enemy.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm not going to sit face to face with anybody, but I forgive and I forget.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't go home and sitting down face to face. It's a trap. God loves you.
My name is Emmanuel Okporua Nefri, and I'm from Delta State. The man of God said that there's a reconciliation going on in my family and that I should learn to forgive and forget. I am here to confirm that prophecy. Actually, there's a reconciliation going on in my family concerning my property, which was sold by my elder sister. It's a parcel of land which I bought some time ago. I moved blocks to start building a house. One day, when I got to the land, I found that all the blocks had been removed. So my neighbor said it was my sister who came to pack those blocks. And I went to her house and I asked her, why did you pack those blocks? She said, is that why you came from Lagos? I said, yes. She said she sold the blocks to eat. I was so angry. In fact, I was so angry to the point that I told her that if I see you in my house, I will throw you down. So since the man of God said, I should forgive her and I should forget, I'm going to call her immediately I leave this place, that from the bottom of my heart, I have forgiven her.
To God be the glory. And of course today, God's word has spoken breakthrough and freedom into your life today. And you believe that that has brought an end to the common calamities of your life?
That is correct. That is true.
To God be the glory. Are you a believer in God?
Yes, I'm a believer.
We thank God Almighty for your life.
Madam, can I speak to you? Be careful of will.
Yes, sir.
Do you understand my language?
Yes, sir. I'm a widow.
You are a widow. Clap for Jesus Christ.
Please, sir.
Come, what is bothering you, the trouble you are having? Just smile, it's over. Okay? Nobody will cheat you.
Amen.
What is for you is for you.
Amen.
Because they have set a trap. They say you should come, you disappoint them twice because you are afraid.
Yes.
So, but I'm telling you, after the deliverance, as you go there, no problem. Let's
Amen.
Go.
My name is Mrs. Akibuli Caroline Shola. I'm from Ondo State. I'm a nurse. This is my first time of coming to this place. The man of God told me to be very careful about the will and that the Lord is going to fight for me. So the prophecy is true because I am a widow. I'm a widow with 5 children. So my husband died 2 years ago. So all the properties have not been shared and nothing was said about it. It was locked up just by the relatives. So what the man of God said was true, that I should be careful about the way and that the Lord is going to fight for me. I really believe that. It is true to a fact that I am the second wife and I'm not from the same town with my husband. So, but the man of God said I should be careful and that the Lord is going to fight for me and that he's going to bless me, yes.
I will pray with you that the Lord will grant you the grace to go and live your life to please Him in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come, I want to speak to you. Yes, this is the second step of marriage now. You see, the first step, how you started your life, it really affects your career. You talk, it's a game, but it's affecting your career. You're under a curse.
Yes, it's so true.
So you keep moving and fall back. It is worse to the extent that you that live comfortably,
yes,
you don't have a place to live again. It has just become worse like that.
Yes.
So it is each woman where you start your career. And you know what I'm talking about.
I understand.
So once this is clear, you move.
Amen.
Because I'm seeing you, your property is somewhere and you are somewhere.
Yes. My name is Kenneth Anezue. I'm from Anambra State. I have a newcomer.
Yes, in the course of the service today, something spectacular actually happened in your life today, which I believe you'll never forget. Can you share with us what actually happened in the course of the first service?
What the man of God said is true, but then in my life, he gave me a prophecy that I married and remarried. There is a woman that my mother married for me, but in terms of that, my wife that I'm married now, I'm with her. Then the second prophecy about you are living somewhere, your property is somewhere. Yes. I came to Lagos to travel out with my passport and other things. Then they robbed me and took whatever I have. Then I left my property at Onitsha and I resided in Lagos here now. So the prophecy he prophesied about me is true. About rising and falling, I'm a Cadillac, I'm at Beggar now. When I bought a car, I cannot be able to sell it. I thank God to be here, and I appreciate it.
To God be the glory. And you believe that this message of prophecy is true for your life?
It's true.
To God be the glory. Are you a believer, sir?
I'm a believer, by the grace of God.
To God be the glory. We believe the situation you have undergone may be to keep you for a new level in life. It may be to strengthen your desire for Christ Jesus, to reform you for a better position in God. And of course, God Almighty does nothing without a reason. And the Bible said, in every situation, God Almighty has something to say. And I believe you have listened to the message of prophecy from the man of God. And we believe that this message will point you to good way, to good life, as you hearken to this message of prophecy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever chain Satan must have used to connect your business, to connect your world, to connect your spiritual life, right now begin to disconnect yourself. In the name of Jesus,
amen.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Father, we pray for those who are under the influence of this telecast. Feed their houses. Heal all that are sick. Bless all that are poor. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Be delivered in Jesus' name. I can hear breakthrough, 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 breakthrough. Hallelujah. Remember, better is not good enough. The best is yet to come.